In this video, we will justify that some languages are not regular, not context-free. These kind of results are sometimes referred as negative results, since they show the limitations of a formalism's expressiveness. Let's start justifying that this language is not regular. Note that it contains exactly the words that start with a certain amount of A's followed by the same amount of B's. For simplicity, we will call it the language ANBN. Intuitively, it already seems non-regular, since automata have a finite number of states, and this will not be enough to remember all the A's seen, which is needed in order to check that there are as many B's as A's. We will prove it by contradiction, supposing that it is regular. If it is so, then there exists a deterministic finite automaton A that recognizes it. Let n be the amount of states of A. If we run the automaton A with n A's in its input, the automaton will run through all the states. The initial state, the state reached after reading an A, the state reached after reading two A's, and so on. Altogether, there are n plus 1 states. Since they amount more than the total number of different states in Q, necessarily two of them are repeated. Therefore, there exist I and J different from 0 and n, such that after reading I A's, we reach the same state that is reached after reading J A's. Thus, the state reached after reading IA's followed by IB's is the same state as the one reached after reading JA's followed by IB's. This state must be an accepting state since A to the I followed by B to the I is in the language. But it also must be rejecting, since A to the J followed by B to the I is not in the language. This is impossible, so we have contradicted the hypothesis and this finishes the proof. The ANBN is a context-free language, since this grammar generates it. This justifies that the inclusion of regular languages in context-free languages is actually a strict inclusion. The technique that we have just seen can be usually used to show the non-regularity of many languages. However, sometimes we will be able to find shorter proof using as known fact that ANBN is not regular. Let's see this with an example. We want to prove that this language is not regular. We proceed by contradiction supposing that it is. Since regular languages are closed and are complementary, we deduce that its complementary is also regular. But this complementary is precisely the language ANBN, which we have proved that it is not regular. We have found a contradiction and this concludes the proof. Note that we have used the property that regularity is preserved under the complementary operation. We know many other closed operations for regular languages, such as union, intersection, concatenation, star, reverse, direct morphism, and inverse morphism. Proceeding analogously to the previous proof, we can show the non-regularity of other languages using these properties. Now we justify that the language ANBNCN is not a context-free language. We proceed by contradiction supposing that it is. Then there exists a context-free grammar G that generates it. Without loss of generality, we can assume that G is in the Chomsky normal form, because we have already seen that any grammar can be converted to a Chomsky normal form, preserving the language. Let n be the number of variables in G. Let's take this word, which is in the language, and thus there exists a derivation tree for it with the rules of G. Note that the amount of leaves in the tree is greater than 2 to the n. Moreover, since the grammar is in Chomsky normal form, all internal nodes have arity at most 2. In fact, all of them have arity 2 except the one just over the leaves. It is straightforward to see that the tree has height greater than n, since trees with height less than or equal to n, with arity at most 2, have at most 2 to the n leaves. Therefore, in this tree exists a path with length greater than n from the root to one of the leaves. Since n is the number of different n variables in G, we can conclude that there exists a path from the root to a leaf where a variable is repeated, say x. So there exists a derivation of this form, and it will contain a subderivation from x like this. Since G is in the Chomsky normal form, there are no lambda productions nor unary productions in G, and so the subderivation from x generates some symbol. It follows that either w2 or w4 have size greater than 0. On the other hand, we can modify the original derivation from x like this. We have repeated the subderivation from x, and so we have this word w. Since it is a terminal word generated from the initial symbol, it must be in the language. It follows that w2 and w4, in the case that they are not empty, they must be composed by a single symbol. Else the sequence w2 w2 or the sequence w4 w4 would insert A's, B's, or C's in the wrong order and W would not be in the language. Summarizing, W has some additional symbol compared to the initial word since either W2 or W4 is not empty, but they either do not add A's or do not add B's or do not add C's. Therefore, it cannot have the same amount of A's, B's, and C's. Thus, it is not in the language. This is a contradiction since we had deduced that it was in the language.